What is up, everybody? We have got VDL week versus the Jeff City Seismitoads. Let's see. They've got a pretty good team. They've got some nice tools. I think the most annoying thing is probably the Zoroark, just not knowing if it's, you know, something else, and then the Togekiss with redirection and, you know, not knowing if it's going to max or not. So, let's see what he brought here. He brought the Dwebble. Are you serious? What is he doing with Dwebble? I know it's got Sturdy. That's hilarious. So I kind of just like Mammoth Swine Tornadus here. In the back, let's go. Do we go Sack Attack Azam? He didn't bring Gastrodon, which is kind of nice. I mean, Heracross looks pretty good. Heracross Alakazam could be interesting. Well, Stack Attack just looks good too, though. Yeah, I don't want to think Blissey looks too good here. Let's go Heracross Zam for Womble, because I know he likes Heracross. We'll see if we even get to use it. Alright. Man, I really wanted to bring Meteor Beam Sack Attacka, but I just couldn't bring myself to. I also threw together this team pretty quickly, so hopefully it does work. Awesome! Awesome, awesome, awesome. Now this is a lead I can work with, because I think he doesn't have any other Levitate bombs. So one of them could be Zoroark. Oh wait, no. We're just Earthquaking here. And I think do we Airstream or do we Knuckle? I feel like we Knuckle the Togekiss, potentially. In case he's... Well, actually, we might want to Airstream first. Do we don't want to... Sure, let's Knuckle the Togekiss. Boost that up. It could be Zoroark, and I don't even think this will kill, but the thing is, Zoroark could be the Duraludon, too. Okay, just use his Follow Me, so it doesn't really matter. See, but the thing is, I could Airstream, I guess. That was a crit. Alright, let's see how much this Earthquake does. Iron Defense. This is still gonna hurt, though. This is a similar set that he ran last week. Is he Shookaberry? No. Okay, delayed. Yeah, it still does big, big damage. Weakness policy. But the thing is, I think with another Earthquake will do, if we Airstream will be faster. Yeah. Another Earthquake will do enough. So if he didn't lead Zoroark, it makes me think that he doesn't have Zoroark in the back. So who could he have? He could have Excadrill, he could have Senescourge. I don't see Dwebble coming in the back, though. So he's maxing Togekiss, maybe? Oh no. No, no, no. Unless he max guards. Could he go for like a max guard yell on or something? But he's gonna die. Helping hand. Yeah, I think he's just Gonzo here. Oh, but he. Well. So he is policy. And the Airstream did enough to KO the next time, so if I Airstream again, it should take out the Togekiss. So he's weakness policy drought. Moldbreaker, Excadrill. Yeah, I mean, there's really no point in revealing that I am, I mean, plus he could be Scarf, but there's also no point in revealing that I have Steel Spike. Because if he's Scarf, Excadrill, he would outspeed if I didn't get the second Airstream off. Because for sure, Tornadus outspeeds. And yeah, I figured that should kill. See the sash. Yeah. Yeah, so now he's gonna find out I'm sash. Which is fine. Now he does have Zoroark, that's so interesting. But I don't think Zoroark has a priority move. There's really no harm in just doing Earthquake Superpower. He's not Sash Zoroark. I don't think he has a priority move. I could be wrong. I guess I could have Ice Sharded, because I knew he wasn't Sash, and but he could have been Chapelberry. So I think this covered for everything. Thing is, I can't exactly do that next time. Like, I could, but I guess he could max right away and just get the weakness policy. The question is he Iron Defense Body Press? Like, I really don't see a reason to do something different than that. It just works so well. Like, what's he gonna do differently here? So he has Helping Hand. But if he maxes right away, he doesn't get. He could Steel Spike. That's the difference. He could Steel Spike. I can't speed swap with Togekiss out there. I really feel like going with the same stuff will just kind of work. Because Heracross and Alakazam in the back just looks so nice. Though. I'm totally airstreaming that. I'm not gonna give him the weakness pause right away. But if he's Zoroark, does a max knuckle actually take him out? Let's max knuckle and ice shard. How does that even come out? I don't even know if that kills it yet. It's not very effective either. I guess I could have crashed. The question is, which one is the Zoroark? One of them's totally got the Zoroark. But yeah, if this doesn't, this actually probably doesn't even kill. And then I'm not even gonna, he's gonna get like a bulldoze or something off. And just, oh, wide blade. Cool. Does this KO? I don't even think this KOs, to be honest. Yeah. So now this gets interesting. You can just wide guard again. I should have crashed. My Esco crashed. GG. So I can knuckle again. Or I could. But I can also swap to here. But I don't know how useful Mammoth Swap is in this case. You get Protect on the level. But if I Steel Spike, does Heracross live this? Because I could Steel Spike the Dwebble. No, Steel Spike doesn't do anything. He's not physical. I could Airstream it with KO. Crap. I actually don't think this is the move. Because Knuckle would have KO'd regardless, so why did I airstream? Yeah, I should have knuckled, because that was plus one. I think Knuckle KO's. It might not have, though. But I didn't give up Heracross, which is nice. But now he's got plus two defense. And now he's got tokens. I'm definitely knuckling here. And protecting. You can do that weird drain punch thing where he activates weakness policy too. Thank you. I'm just gonna get rid of this. Knock the Stone Edge. Yeah. Oh, he could be Charty Berry. No, he's gonna be Charty Berry. Oh, I should have been Smart Strike, not Stone Edge. I forgot that his Togekiss always dies to rock moves. Dang it, he's gonna be Charty Berry. Dang it. Crit. Crit through. No, that would have killed potential. This is bad. This is real bad. Because I don't want to give him weakness policy. Oh, man. And I don't know if an Alakazam can't beat Zoroark in the back, but neither can Mamoswine. I have to have Tornadus beat him. So who actually looks good here is the question. There's nobody. I could go Mamoswine and Protect, and maybe get an Iron Tail off. But he's got three Steel Spikes. I mean, a Psychic... He could be... No, he's not AV. So a Psychic will actually still do decent damage on him. I think an Acrobatics plus an Ice Shard should KO. Actually, that's huge, though. Because now I'm plus four Tornadus. What does he go for? Need to see who he brings out next. Yeah, I need to Ice Shard this Togekiss and hope he goes in Tornadus again. Protecting Togekiss is just so nice here, though. That would be so smart. I should've just risked the Iron Tail. Okay, cool, cool, cool. So he's just attacking. Is he going for Dazzling Gleam? Go for another Thumb. Oh, he Flash Cannons to guarantee the hit. That's huge. Who is he having back, though? So he had Dwebble. Excadrill. So the question is, who can Tornadus beat? Okay, wait. Excadrill Sash. Know that. I think we superpower. We need to get rid of them. Protect. What about this? Then we can speed swap Earthquake. I mean, I don't even think this kills. Because they're both faster than Mamoswine, which sucks. Let's see how much this does. It doesn't kill. So now, okay, no, this is gonna be clutch. So now what we do is we speed swap the mammoth swine, get the earth, but if I earthquake, I'm gonna die. So here's a, cause I could speed swap earthquake, but then Alec is, but if he earthquakes, he's not gonna earthquake though, is he? He's probably gonna iron head. I could risk the speed swap earthquake. A psychic definitely KOs Groudon here though, right? But the question is, does a psychic KO the Excadrill? I'm thinking I'm not earthquaking anyways. I think I have to speed swap with earthquake. As long as he doesn't go for earthquake. Because as long as he doesn't go for earthquake and get the double KO. Gosh dang it. Oh man, I don't think that would have killed. I should have psychicked. Oh, that was so silly. I should have psychicked. The problem is, I think I had to hope. Well, the problem is, if I psychic the Duraludon and KO the Duraludon, then I have to. So if I psychic Duraludon and KO the Duraludon, then I'd have to get an attack off of Mammoth, I'd have to Ice Shard. Let's see. Do we just go with the speed swap right away? Let's see. I think we go with the speed swap. If he goes Togekiss, Togekiss Excadrill would suck. But we just max and we go for the Blissey right away. And then we let's see. I think we need Tornadus. This is so risky. Yeah, the problem there was, okay, let's say a psychic can take out the Groudon. Then he has an Excadrill, which needs two hits to KO. And if I Ice Shard him, I don't know how much that does with Mammoth Swine. But if he takes out... Actually, if he Earthquakes, then Alexander's low, and then does a Psychic finish off with him as a mission. Okay, so this is huge. So I can just get a Body Press off right away? That's the thing, is I don't have to max. I can still max Tornadus in the back. Or I could go for max Steel Spikes. Which I kinda like. Max Tornadus in the back. I don't think I need you. Thank you. But I'm really glad I didn't just speed spot body testing. Now the thing is, you might be saying, well, he can just go into Excadrill if I kill the Dwebble here, which I probably will put him. And if he does do that, well, I've already got a Steel Spike, and I'll get a second Steel Spike if I took this. Oh, I forgot he's sturdy. Oh my gosh, what if he counters? Does he have counter? Oh my gosh, I forgot he's got counter. Oh, it just says X Scissor. Oh, it doesn't kill Alakazam though, because I put in HP investment. So now I Steel Spike and I swap in the Blissey, I guess. Or I can get a Tornado. I can get Tornadus to boost too, actually. Because he's gonna X Scissor. But Blissey just looks so nice here. Because I can just start setting up. Getting Blissey defense boosts with this set is so annoying. Oh, but we don't kill. Oh, that actually sucks. What if he has Yawn or something? That does nothing. That Scissor. Whoa. Is that crit? No, it actually just does disgusting damage. We get another max to spike off. And then let's. Fry attack. Actually, a max extra would be annoying here. Yeah, because if we leave Dwebble on the field, it just becomes super annoying for him. This is Sash Excadrill. If I just put Tornadus on the field, like, there's nothing he could do. Tornadus was definitely the move. I should just switch to Tornadus there, actually. Dang. So with all these defense boosts, let's think about this. Okay, so the thing is, I don't think he... Oh, what are we right now? Plus four. Okay, if I body press and switch to Tornadus, I think we're free here. Yeah, I don't know why I reset that. Let's see, that was silly. Now the reason we're body pressing the bubble is to get the beast boost and get one more defense boost. Let's see how much this does. Oh my god, that's times four! That's times four effective. Oh my goodness. Now he's got Duraludon. Okay, now, if we body press the Excadrill and Acrobatics, we get one more defense boost. And does the Duraludon KO? I don't think he does. Yeah, I don't think he does. I wonder if he's maxing the Excadrill here. Let's see. It's neutral, I'm AV. Without weakness policy, I don't think it KOs. See, because he wants to get the earthquake off to get his own weakness policy, but I'm gonna kill him before that. Oh my gosh, he max guards. Oh crap, I made a Huckazam faster. Forgot. That was silly. But it's okay, because we still get the KO there. Alright, now here's the big question, everybody. Does a plus 4 max defense stack attack a Dynamax Duraludon? Here's the big question. Let's see it. Okos. We're going for Okos. Oh baby, stack attacker, you'll love to see it. Oh man, I should have made Alakazam 1 point slower than Tornadus, then I could have got the 4-0 with stack attacker. Jeez. All right, well, GG's to Jeff. That was an intense game two. Really good set. That'll wrap up week three of the VDL. We squeak out with a 2-1 there. But yeah, it was fun. And GG's to Jeff. We'll see everybody later.